Today I'm in Beverly Hills and I'm getting elective surgery on my face and my neck.
And get that double chin removed to kind of bring that tissue closer to my jawline. Being 6'9 definitely affects how people see my chin. It's not like people are looking down at me, so it's this angle. Woo!
They're like this, straightening up at me, and I'm like,
lowering over them.
Hi, are you Lindsay?
Hi, yes.
Hi, I'm Sharon. Nice to meet you.
Hi, good to meet you.
Oh, you're tall. Yeah. Okay, come on in.
I've wanted to do this for so long, since I'm in my teens.
With this elective surgery, it's gonna help me get more work as an actress. I
think it's gonna give me that self-confidence that will radiate on camera.
So you can have a seat right in here.
Thanks.
Make sure that you fit through the doorway.
I'm a little nervous for this because I haven't had surgery in quite a long time.
I've had a couple of elective surgeries done in the past, just on my chest.
This is your outfit for today. This is your gown. We're gonna have you leave it open in the back. I hope it's long enough.
Right.
The morning of the surgery, I was feeling so much anticipation and like anxiety about the risk of surgery and going under the knife and having a terrible recovery. But I think that the biggest thing that I was feeling was hunger. I was really hungry and I was getting a little bit hangry. Hangry is hungry angry. Is real.
Ow. I match. Oh, they got little paw prints on them. Like a diaper. Oh.
I love these things.
The new Lindsay is gonna have a new little face without that little tuck. We're leaving that in the past. I like that.
Hey. Hey, how are you?
Good.
So I'm gonna mark you, okay?
Okay.
And then we'll go over any final questions that you might have.
Okay. I'm going to put your chair up here.
I've never operated on someone of Lindsay's stature. I believe the tallest patient I've ever operated on is probably somewhere around 6'2". So what I want you to do, if you can, scoot your legs over this way.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just sorry. I'm a little fearful of heights. It's ridiculous. It's not that tall.
You're afraid of heights?
Yeah.
That's funny. Her size is a little out of the ordinary as far as her height, and we just need to make sure that the operating table is long enough for her.
Okay. So the incision, like we talked about, is going to be underneath your chin.
Okay.
Okay? So just look straight at me, and I'm going to do a mark right in the midline here.
A little incision here. Here. Bye.
Never examined anyone from this. But I could easily see under your chin.
I don't know what I'm gonna look like after surgery. I don't know if I'm gonna look like a mummy or I should figure that out.
I'm gonna go straight into here. There's your bed for the next couple hours.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna take this out from around you. I'm gonna untie anything if you have. Nope, good. So your head's gonna go on that little pillow there.
Sorry. Challenging.
I don't feel overall that her size is going to affect the procedure. However, there may be a few minor adjustments that I may have to make depending on her anatomy.
How you feeling? Okay?
Yeah.
I'm gonna hook you up to a bunch of monitors, okay? Oh, good. Your feet. Good.
So we were anticipating that we might have to make minor adjustments to the operating table to accommodate Lindsay's size. However, the operating table is 7 feet long, so she just fit.
And I'll be giving you some medicines right away to make you feel a little bit more relaxed, okay? So I want you nice and relaxed.
I think that people don't understand, when you are taller, you are bigger. I do have so much more mass. It does take a lot more to put me out. But you know, whenever you go under anesthesia, you kind of worry what you're gonna say. It's like being really, really drunk.
I feel like I'm being tied up. I'm a little bit nervous about the upcoming surgery, but I'm really excited because I will wake up and look like a different person.
Deep breaths. Nice deep breaths, Lindsay.
I feel like I've been blowing balloons for like 5 days.
And you feel drowsy or?
It's like being drunk and then like hit in the face. And then like blowing up balloons after you were like pummeled. I feel like when I'm talking, I have gauze in my mouth, like, but I feel like I'm hoarding food or something.
God, I can't even get it on my bloody little fork.
Oh, sorry, I dropped the knife.
Woke up and you were ranting, and then you probably don't remember this about all the different foods you wanted to eat.
Bacon, what? Ow.
Burgers.
Ow. I'm gonna rip a stitch. You don't have to eat that.
Yeah. It's soft beef, it's not like tough. So.
Yeah. I don't know what I said, but I'm sure I meant it. Thank you, baby.
Do you need a hand up or you're right? You good? You're not gonna fall over? sorry, I won't let you laugh.
The sutures will come out in 6 days. How ridiculous do I look?
Go and have a look.
Oh man. When all the swelling goes down, like, I'm kind of excited to see what's underneath it and like how this is going to help me further my career. When I saw myself in the mirror when I got home, I was confused because I was like, I didn't get anything done here. So I thought that maybe I had brain surgery or something. And I peeked under there and there's nothing under there. It's just to hold it all together. But it did worry me a little. I'm out.